my village, let me say my village, Sangha local government of Kaduna State, this is a traditional drink that we make. It's been from generation to generation. It's been passed down and passed down. It's been passed down to us. And since then, this recipe has really been very effective. It has really been very helpful to mothers. And I thought to share it. Why not share to everybody so that women will be helped and families will be helped too. Back to my YouTube channel, it's your girl again, Rachel Silas. So you're very welcome, my returning subscribers. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. For new subscribers, you're highly welcome. Please continue to watch me, continue to like my videos, comment, share my videos. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. So today's video is for breastfeeding mothers and intending mothers, especially breastfeeding mothers that are having problems in breastfeeding their children due to lack of milk, enough milk in their breast, and thereby making them to spend lots of money in baby foods and the rest. So this recipe is going to help you so much. You are going to save tons and tons of money. In my village, let me say my village, Sangha local government of Kaduna State, this is a traditional drink that we make. It's been from generation to generation. It's been passed down and passed down. It's been passed down to us. And since then, this recipe has really been very effective. It has really been very helpful to mothers. And I thought to share it. Why not share to everybody so that women will be helped and families will be helped too. So this particular recipe, yeah, if somebody before, in times of the olden, let me not say olden days because I'm not old, okay, the times of, let me say from when I was growing up, anybody that makes this recipe, makes this drink and brings for you, you must be really special to that person. I mean, very special, because the process of making this recipe is not easy, man. I know. During those times, there are no machines that ease the work of grinding. So, but now, everything made easy with blenders and electronics. So, everything is going to be easier for you. It's rice and this black seed. I think they call it sesame or something like that. But sesame. I'm going to post the video. You are going to watch the tutorial anyways. So this recipe I'm talking about, immediately you take it, give it few hours, everything, your breast will start pumping whole lot of milk. I know very many people start copying this thing. I make my own, it's very special, which I add other things, but it's just two ingredients that you need for this recipe. You need rice, that rice that they use for rice pudding. Some people from my state, we call it, from the northern states anyways, we call it Shinkafon Tuo. Well, I don't know the region you are from. I don't know how you call it, but we call it Tuo Shinkafa or Shinkafon Tuo. Shinkafon Tuo, let me say Shinkafon Tuo. You use it and you use Ridi. Ridi is not black seed, sorry, is sesame seed. We use sesame seed, you toast it a bit, the sesame seed, you wash it first and dry them. Wash your rice, wash your sesame seed, then you dry them to remove all the dirt. Please, watch the video to the end. Watch it to the end. If you have any other questions, please send me a message on my DM on Instagram, Shilami1, or Facebook, Rachel Silas Jr. And also comment below with your questions and your feedbacks. I'm ready to answer all your messages. This recipe will help you a lot, so please share with somebody that is struggling. Share with somebody that is struggling to breastfeed their child. I'm so grateful to you. Please don't forget to share my video. I love you so much. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl again, Rachel Silas. So you're very welcome, my returning subscribers. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. For new subscribers, you're highly welcome. Please continue to watch me, continue to like my videos, comment, share my videos. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. So today's video is for breastfeeding mothers and intending mothers, especially breastfeeding mothers that are having problems in breastfeeding their children due to lack of milk, enough milk in their breast, and thereby making them to spend lots of money in baby foods and the rest. So this recipe is going to help you so much. You are going to save tons and tons of money. In my village, let me say my village, Sanga local government of Kaduna State, this is a traditional drink that we make. It's been from generation to generations. It's been passed down and passed down. It's been passed down to us. And since then, this recipe has really been very effective. It has really been very helpful to mothers. And I thought to share it. Why not share to everybody so that women will be helped and families will be helped too. So this particular recipe, yeah, if somebody before, in times of the olden, let me not say olden days because I'm not old, okay, the times of, let me say from when I was growing up, sure, anybody that makes this recipe, makes this drink and brings for you, you must be really special to that person. I mean, very special, because the process of making this recipe is not easy, man. I know during those times, there are no machines that ease the work of grinding. So, but now, everything made easy with blenders and electronics, sure. So, everything is going to be easier for you. It's rice and this black seed. I think they call it sesame or something like that. But sesame, I'm going to post the video. You're going to watch the tutorial anyways. So this recipe I'm talking about, immediately you take it, give it few hours, yeah, everything, your breast will start pumping whole lot of milk. I know very many people start copying this thing. I make my own, it's very special, which I add other things, but it's just two ingredients that you need for this recipe. You need rice, that rice that they use for rice pudding. Some people from my state, we call it, from the northern states anyways, we call it Shinkafon Tuo. Well, I don't know the region you are from. I don't know how you call it, but we call it Tuo Shinkafa or Shinkafon Tuo. Shinkafon Tuo, let me say Shinkafon Tuo. You use it and you use Ridi. Ridi is not black, sorry, is sesame seed. We use sesame seed, you toast it a bit, the sesame seed, you wash it first and dry them. Wash your rice, wash your sesame seed, then you dry them to remove all the dirt. Please, watch the video to the end, If you have any other questions, please send me a message on my DM, on Instagram, Shilami1, or Facebook, Rachel Silas Jr. And also comment below with your questions and your feedbacks. I'm ready to answer all your messages. This recipe will help you a lot, so please share with somebody that is struggling. Share with somebody that is struggling to breastfeed their child. I'm so grateful to you. Please don't forget to share my video. I love you so much. So we are going to take 2 cups of rice. This type of rice is for making fufu, tuo. The one Hausa people call it tuo shing. Shinkafon Tuo. This is Shinkafon Tuo, the one you use to make your pudding, like rice pudding. So you take 2 cups of it, this rice, then you soak it. For now, I'm going to use, for the sake of this video, I'm going to use hot water so that it will be fast, it will soak on time. So you soak it, you soak the rice and let it sit until it's soft. Let it sit and be soft. I think 30 minutes to 1 hour is enough for this rice to soak. So after soaking, we are going to wash it and then dry it. The purpose of this washing is to get rid of all the dirt, make sure we are using proper rice, healthy rice and clean rice, okay?
So you are going to soak it and leave it for, I'm not going to close it because I'm using hot water. Normally I use cold water when I have time, but when I don't have time I use hot water.
Hi guys, so this is the soaked rice. This is how it looks when you soak it. I soaked it for over 1 hour. You see, this is how it's looking. It's very soft. So after washing it and removing the stones, you dry it. So I'm drying it on a tray. I can't take it outside, so all these flies that are flying around, I can't let them sit on it. So I'm spreading it here. I pray it dries quickly so that I'll continue on time. I need to save time. Hi guys, so I can't wait, really. I can't wait to dry it. Since we are still going to add water to it, let me just try and blend it like that. But normal, sometimes the way we make it dry, let it dry, sit and dry first. So I'm just going to pour it into the blender. Make sure your hands are washed though. Wash your hands before you do this. Make sure your nails are super clean before you do this. I'm just going to leave this like this. You add water. I've strained it. The task is very tasky. This one is the liquid part, is the liquid type, because both of them are liquid types, sure. Because at the end of the day you have to soak it, you have to use liquid to drink it. You have to kind of make it into a paste, a runny paste to drink it. But some people eat it, eat a very thick paste of it. But for a breastfeeding mother, I prefer you use the liquid paste to drink. It's better you use the liquid one. So I'm done straining. We are moving to the next part. So this is 1/4 cup of sesame seed. I'm going to toast it for a bit. It's not washed yet. I want to toast it before I rinse it, because I can't wait for it to dry. I'm trying to save time here. Yeah, so I'm stirring it so that it doesn't burn. I don't want it to burn. Keep stirring it. Make sure it's on low heat though. Let it be on low heat. When you are stirring, you begin to perceive the smell, the very nice scent of the sesame coming out. Just pop it. For me, I'll just stir it for like 3 to 5 minutes. So this is how our paste is looking like. It's runny. So I'm adding the sesame seed. You can reach out for my spoon. Still has water, so I'm straining it. I'm adding sugar. You can add sugar according to how you like sugar, but if you don't like sugar, it's not necessary for you to add. So for me, I'll be adding and tasting till I get my desired taste. Scary.